All right, everyone. So I recently replaced my Pentair SuperFlo pool pump that's finally worn out and used the opportunity to upgrade my system to a variable speed pump. This is the Pentair SuperFlo. And what this allows me to do is dial in the RPMs so that I can control how many gallons per minute my pool pump runs at. And to figure that out, though, I don't have a flow meter. So I looked up how to do a flow calculation using the pressure gauge on the filter and then adding a vacuum gauge in line on the pool pump here on the suction side. So I'm gonna go ahead and screw this Measure Man vacuum gauge into the suction side of the pool pump here. And then using the power of math, I'm gonna be able to figure out my total dynamic head. And then I'm gonna show you how to use the Pentair performance chart to figure out the gallons per minute through the system, depending on the RPMs that you have it set to, crossed with your total dynamic head in the system. So let's go ahead and get started by relieving the pressure in the system. Now I'm just going to go ahead and unscrew this drain cap. All right, so now here at the pump, I'm going to set it to speed 2. So it's going to start priming, and then it should go into 3000 RPM once it's done, and I'll check my readings after that. All right, so now we're at 3000 RPM, so let's check our gauges. So on the top of the filter, we have the pressure gauge, and that's reading at about 12 bar right now. And it looks like our vacuum reading is at right about 12, so now let's record that. So now we're gonna take the vacuum number and the pressure number, and we're gonna multiply those accordingly, and then add them together, which will get us our total dynamic head. And we got the reading at 3000, so let's grab what the curve is at 2200 RPM as well. So let's crank this up a little bit. And let's check the readings again. So now at 2200 RPM, we're at 7 bars of pressure. And it looks like we're at about 6 on the vacuum. And now for the last curve, let's bring it down to 1400. And now at 1400 RPM, let's see where we're at. So about 2 bars of pressure. I'll say about 2 bars of vacuum as well. All right, so over here on the left, I've pasted the performance curve data for my variable speed Pentair SuperFlo pump from the instruction manual. And as you can see, it has different performance curves for the different RPMs that I've tested under. So using this chart, I can track over from the left where it has my total dynamic head and then see where it intersects with the gallons per minute down at the bottom, which will give me my flow rate, which will let me determine how long I want to run my pool pump for. So to get my gallons per minute, I just need to figure out my total dynamic head using the pressure and vacuum readings I took outside. So on the right side here, you can see that I've recorded the various pressure and vacuum readings at the different RPMs that line up with those performance curves on the left here. So all I need to do is multiply these readings by these factors here and then sum the products to get me my total dynamic head at each RPM. So for example, at 3000 RPM, I had a pressure reading and vacuum reading both of 12, and you just multiply the pressure reading times 2.31 and the vacuum reading by 1.3, and that gives me 27.2 and 15.6, which when added together comes out to 43.32, so we'll round that to about 43. So if we look on the left side here for the 3000 RPM curve, which is this gold color here, and look for where we'd say about 43 lies on the graph, about here, and track over, you can see that we land somewhere between the upper 60s to just under 70 gallons per minute. So I'll call that about 65 gallons per minute down here at the bottom. And your total dynamic head is going to drop at a lower RPM, so you need to use a different curve. So at 2200 RPM, my pressure and vacuum readings were 7 and 6 respectively. So again, we use the same factor to multiply those values. So now I have 16.17 and 7.8, and if you add those together, we have just about 24 if you round up. So similarly, we're going to look for the 2200 RPM curve here, which is the gray line. Look for 24. Track that across and then go down, and that gives us about 45 gallons per minute. So now that I know how many gallons per minute my pool pump is pushing, I can figure out how long I need to run my pump to filter all the water in my pool at least once per day. So I have 19,000 gallons here. The PVC plumbing for my pool is only 1.5 inches and you're supposed to stay under 51 gallons per minute at that diameter. So I don't want to run too fast. And to work well with my solar heater, I need to push a minimum of 32 gallons per minute. So running at 3,000 RPMs would be overkill because that would get me 65 gallons per minute. 2,200 RPMs would work out at 45 gallons per minute, and so would 1,400 RPMs. But all these readings were taken with the solar off. So with the solar diverter on, where it was actually sending water up to my roof to be heated by the solar coils, that increases the total dynamic head. Because now I'm pumping the water higher, about 10 feet up onto my roof, and then it has to go through even more tubing, which adds more friction as it runs through the solar collectors. And that all served to increase the dynamic head. So at 3,000 RPMs with the solar on, I actually lost about 10 gallons per minute. But at 1,400 RPM, it couldn't get it up to the roof. So 1400 RPM is too low for it to work with solar turned on. But 3000 RPMs again is giving me still over 51 gallons per minute. So that's still too fast on the RPM side of things. So I'd want to slow down the pump, which is fine because that actually uses less electricity, which is good for me. So if I slowed things down to a single speed at 2200 RPMs, I would get 37 gallons per minute through the system, which works out fine because it's lower than 51 and it's above the 32 gallons per minute that my solar panels require, which allows me to have a 9 hour runtime if I just kept the pump at a single speed. Because at the end of 9 hours, if I took those 9 hours times 37 gallons per minute times 60 minutes in an hour, I would have filtered just under 20,000 gallons of water. All right, so in this table below, I worked out a balance to run higher speed for some of the day to let my suction side pool cleaner climb the walls, but remain in an efficient lower speed setting for the rest of the day, which lets me keep my water circulating longer while using less electricity overall. So as you can see here at 1900 RPMs, we're only using 350 watts, while the pump will use 775 watts to run at 2600 RPM. So I'm gonna keep my pump at 1900 RPMs for most of the day. It's gonna keep everything nice and quiet and efficient. So after a 9 hour runtime, I'll have filtered about 19,380 gallons through my system, and I'll coincide my runtime to match when the sun is up so that I can collect that solar heat from my pool most effectively. So let me know in the comments if this video helped you with making your pool run more energy efficient. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel for more great smart home tips, and thanks for watching.